Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing well. Today's video is going to be my IUD experience, and more specifically, my copper IUD experience video. I wanted to wait a full year of me having a copper IUD before going into this video and explaining my experience, my process, what it was like when I got it in, but also what it's like a year later. So I wanted to wait, and that has, the time has come. It has been a year, and so I'm finally able to sit down and film this video for you guys and answer some questions I got on Instagram and just walk you through the process of birth control via IUD. So I'm gonna start off the video kind of telling you guys how I decided to go with an IUD versus other birth controls and kind of what I kind of concluded with what would fit best with my lifestyle, because finding a birth control that works for you and your lifestyle is so important. And I was actually on the pill for about 7 years. I took Yasmin, and I originally went on it when I was in high school. I went on it for acne, and I took that for a very, very long time before a doctor basically said to me that I'm at a really high risk of stroke because I had migraines and things like that. I did a whole video on it, so if you guys are interested in hearing my experience with the pill and why I was on it for 7 years and then why I came off of it, I will have that video linked down below, because I think it's really important to kind of share experiences. Obviously, in the moment, the pill seemed right, it was good, and it was working well for me, but then it wasn't, and so I then had to change my trajectory and kind of go with a different option. So essentially, I was on the pill for about 7 years, kind of on and off as it went, but you guys can learn more about that in the video if you're interested. And then I came off of any type of birth control for about a year, I think it was. I just wanted to see what my body did regularly, what my regular acne was like, what my regular period was like, because I had not known, and I started taking birth control at such a young age, and it had hormones and all these things that I just truly didn't know what my body was gonna be like naturally, and like what my regular cycle and all that kind of stuff would be. So I was just kind of curious to see how my body would regulate. After about a year, I did decide that it would be best if I went back on some sort of birth control. I knew that there was a lot more options that I knew about these days, and I just wanted to try and find something that I would feel comfortable taking, would benefit me, and also the huge, big kind of overlaying reason I wanted to get onto a birth control is because I'm a very worried person, and I do not want to get pregnant when I don't plan to, if that makes sense. It's one of my like biggest worries, and I just like, at the age I am, I don't know how I would handle that and if something did occur. So I obviously just want to prevent it until I'm ready to have children. So I decided that I would go on to a birth control and kind of just decide. I looked into the shot, I looked into like a non-hormonal birth control pill, and I kind of came to the conclusion that I didn't want to be taking, obviously, something that had hormones, because I couldn't because of previous experiences, but I also didn't want to take something every single day, and with the shot, you have to get it like every month, and none of those seemed good to me. And it actually took a lot of convincing from like friends and other people and other videos I watched to actually move forward with getting an IUD. It was suggested by my doctor, and I really, really enjoyed the fact that you can get them for like 5 to 10 years, which I thought was really great, because if I got it when I did, 5 years, I'll be 28, I'll probably be, you know, looking to possibly have kids, maybe, who knows what the future holds, but it seemed more possible and just seemed like a really safe and good option. Also the fact that it's 99% effective. A couple of the other reasons before we get into the procedure on how an IUD works. The reasons I went with the copper IUD is because, again, it has no hormones. It's relatively on the inexpensive side compared to some other IUDs. I believe in Canada, I'm in Vancouver, if you guys are curious about location. I'm in Vancouver, Canada, and my copper IUD, I think, cost about like $75 for the 5 year one. It'll change, but the hormonal ones are definitely more expensive. Sometimes insurance and covers it, but it totally obviously depends on where you are. Also too, with the copper IUD, this wasn't like a huge thing for me, but if you guys are looking to conceive like relatively soon, some other birth controls kind of have this window where you're not going to be able to after you stop taking certain types of birth control, but with the IUD you can take it out and just start trying to have a baby pretty well pretty instantly. So I like that aspect, and of course just the longevity of having it in for 5 years, not having to worry about it and not having to worry about taking something every single day. Now when it comes to periods, my regular period during that year that I wasn't taking any birth control was pretty light compared to what I had known most people to have as irregular periods. And so when my doctor said that the copper IUD would make your periods worse when you go on it, I wasn't super turned off to that because my periods were pretty normal, pretty light. Honestly, some days I could just get away with like a panty liner, and my cramps and everything were like super, super minimal. And so having an increase or having a worse period didn't really sound that horrible to me, whereas I feel like some women will go on to a birth control to help their periods and help cramping and all that kind of stuff, which we'll get into in a sec. So yeah, I was totally game for that. I was like, if it's really that bad, then I can switch IUDs and do something else, but I definitely wanna try the copper one and give it a go. So when it comes to the procedure of getting an IUD in, for me, my experience was I had to call my local health clinic that I decided to go with. I obviously did my research, asked friends, read reviews, all of that kind of stuff. You wanna make sure you're going somewhere safe and that you trust. And my clinic also does like abortions and different things like that. So they're very well known and it seemed like a very, very safe and clean space. So I was willing to do that. And also the wait list for an IUD was, I think, about like 2 months, which I'm the kind of person that's so impatient, but also just like waiting for 2 months for like your IUD to go in is like kind of scary because you're like, oh, it's getting closer. Anyway, so I had to book my appointment kind of far out. And when it came time to my actual appointment, also too, you can get your IUD put in at any time in your cycle. From what I gather from them, that didn't really matter. So if you had your period or not, doesn't really matter, they can still put it in. So I had Cody drive me to the clinic that day and I did take some Advil before I went in because I know that you can experience some cramping. I also wore my period proof underwear and you're supposed to bring a pad. And so it's all very, very secure. Cody couldn't come into the procedure room or anything with me. He had to stay in the lobby. Again, it's probably because of the abortions and safety and all that kind of stuff, which obviously is totally understandable and makes it feel like a really safe space, which is really cool and very confidential, which is good. So anyway, I got brought back into the room and I had to sit in just a chair. I believe you put like a little like skirt on. This was a year ago, so like I don't really remember every single detail. But you sit in that chair for a while until you're called into the room and you go in and you lay down. And I believe they did like a pap smear and some other blood tests, just because while you're there they do testing for other things. And I actually had never had a pap smear. My doctor kept saying that you had to be 25 and all these things. For me, it just kept getting pushed off, which I feel like is something so many people everywhere have been like, you haven't had one? How have you not had one? It's crazy. All these things. But I just like, I didn't have any issues and like, I didn't really need to have any of that done. So anyway, they did that while I was there. So I have technically had one now. So I lie down and with not having a pap smear, I have never had the clamps to open up my stuff. And that was a new feeling. Obviously, if you've had that done, you'll know what that feels like, but it's not comfortable. Anyway, so I was like, really just breathing through the whole situation because I knew that it was going to be painful. Everyone tells you. I don't think there's someone on the planet that says this isn't painful. If it isn't for you, that is so great, but I'm not gonna lie, this was probably the most pain I've ever felt. And this is gonna be graphic. But what happens is they open you up, they do all the testing and stuff, and then the doctor basically has the IUD that goes in and flips open on like a little, I wanna say straw thing. I don't know the technical terms, and obviously I'm lying down when this is happening. I'm not watching. And so she kind of counts me in and tells me it's going to feel like one large, very intense cramp, and then it will subside. And so that will be when she like inserts it and then takes it out. And she does count me in and she tells me how it's gonna be. And so I just basically am breathing through the whole thing, and the feeling of having it put in you is like just one big gasp. I basically just went, held, and it was in pain, and then it was released. And then she said we were done, and that was it. And I was like, okay, that was not a great feeling. It was very, 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 very painful. It's, like I said, probably the most pain I've ever experienced in my life. In that moment, I truly don't know how people have babies. You guys are super years. I really am not looking forward to that pain, but having that put in, having it subside, and then basically just sitting up and seeing all of the blood that then is around, that's why they tell you to bring the pad and you're able to clean yourself up. Yeah, you basically just have to go back to the chair. They put a heating pad on you, and right away my cramps were not that bad. I was, I think they give you something to take to make it easier. I'm not quite sure. I don't remember that part. I apologize about that. But I was just sitting there for quite a while, kind of just like, I honestly was like waiting for the cramps to like set in and get bad, but they weren't that bad in the moment. It was kind of just like the trauma of having something, you know, just put in you. And so I was just sitting there kind of waiting, had the heating pad, which was really nice, feeling comfy, little uncomfortable, obviously, but if you've ever had cramps, it's kind of just the same feeling. And then after a while, I was able to leave because I was feeling fine. So I walked out and I got home, and I don't think I went to dance that night. I can't really remember. I might have planned it for a different day so I didn't have to, but the cramps for the next week, I feel like the second and third day were probably the worst. They weren't that bad that I remember being in a lot of pain. I just remember taking Advil or whatever I was able to take, using my home heating pad and just kind of waiting for them to subside. And then, yeah, that was pretty much it for my procedure. It was pretty quick. The lead up and having to wait for the appointment for a couple months was kind of difficult. And then obviously not having had a pap smear and not having any feeling of what this kind of procedure would even feel like I couldn't even imagine what it would feel like. And now that I know, I'm like, oh yeah, that's not great. But the fact that it is something that is going to be my birth control for 5 years and I'm not gonna have to deal with getting it out until I'm like 28 was kind of worth it for me in the long run. I should also note that before you go in to get your ID, I was actually brought into like a counseling room and got to talk with someone one-on-one to actually decide if this is something I wanted to do, if it was right for me, if the copper one was right for me. She kind of talked about all of them. And even though she said that the copper one technically doesn't obviously have hormones, the other ones have such low percentage of hormones being released at a time that it's not the same as the pill, obviously. So in that moment, I kind of had like second guesses on which one I wanted to go with, but I did really want to try the copper one just because of the no hormones thing. And I told myself if it doesn't work or it makes my period a lot worse, then I can always come back and have it switched out. It really like wasn't a big deal and I kind of just wanted to try it and see. So now I want to get into how my cycle and my periods have been since getting my IUD 1 year ago. So the first like 3 to 6 months, I'd say my periods definitely were worse. Like I said, I had such light, easy, breezy periods. What a time that was. They're not like that anymore, especially for the first 3 months. My periods were increasingly heavier. I could not imagine how much women bleed. Like, I truly did not know a life like this, and it made me realize that some girls just have this naturally, which I feel so bad for. And I understand a lot of like the breast tenderness and like the horrible, horrible cramps that make you like bedridden and all of that stuff now, because it was definitely pretty painful for the first like three to six months. I would say there was definitely one day of my period that I would be cramping so bad that I would just want to stay in bed. Luckily, I am very grateful that I work from home, so I'm able to do that, and I just would set up my laptop and work from home in those days and have my heating pad. And when it came to bleeding, I had not known a life of bleeding that much, so I invested in a bunch of period-proof underwear and just kind of got into a new routine of what my period products would look like. If you guys would be interested, I kind of have been wanting to do an updated period routine because I did one a long time ago, but my period routine has definitely changed since then. So let me know if you guys would be interested in that and seeing all the products and tips and tricks I personally like to use, especially now that my periods are heavier. But yeah, I basically just got adjusted to a life of bleeding more, and I knew that it took a while for your body to get adjusted to the IUD, so I was just kind of crossing my fingers and hoping that this wouldn't be forever. And I also was not used to bleeding that heavily and intensely for 7 full days. It was so annoying because for someone that had normally had a period for like 4 days and having it be so light, I was experiencing the cramping, definitely the bloating. I've always had bloating when it comes to my period, but the bleeding for 7 straight days was like kind of an adjustment, and I was just like, this is ridiculous. I am happy to say though that my periods did end up regulating out a little bit more and being easier. They definitely are nowhere near what they were before my IUD, but they're not nearly as bad as what they were in the beginning. I still experience cramping, and I would say like every second period gets like a day of really bad cramping. I just do kind of my same routine of Advil, heating pad, and all that kind of stuff. And my bleeding, I would say, has gone from 7 days down to like 5, but only a couple like super intense days, which is really nice. That was kind of what I was concerned about the most, but it did end up regulating out. I think they say like it'll take 3 months for it to adjust. I would say for me, it took about 6. So that's kind of something to keep in mind if you guys are going through with an IUD. Also too, I didn't mention this in the beginning, but I personally wanted to go with a copper IUD because I wanted to keep my period. I know that when you go on some IUDs or other birth controls, you can actually lose your period completely. And as someone that does eventually want to have babies, and I'm just, I don't know, I don't hate my period. I'm not that girl that like can't, I mean, I should be now after what I experienced, but I still really wanted to have a regular period. It's something I just personally want to have, and so having a little bit of a heavier period seemed fine at the time. It is fine, but just in case you guys were wondering why I would even want to go with something that keeps your period and makes it worse, which probably sounds crazy to some of you, but when you come from a period that wasn't that bad, it didn't really seem that big of a jump. And that's pretty well my whole experience and kind of all the things that I had jotted down in my notes to tell you guys about my experience and what it's like 1 year later. I did ask you on Instagram for any questions just in case I missed anything in my own notes, so I want to answer a couple questions that I got. And one of the questions is, did it cause any side effects? Definitely no side effects other than the fact that my periods are a lot heavier and more intense, but I was noted of that. But with having no hormones in my IUD, I haven't really experienced any like weight gain or acne increase or, you know, anything that would be caused by the IUD. So not really any side effects other than the ones that are stated and told to you beforehand. The next question is, any pain during sex with it? And I would say no, nothing has really changed. Nothing has been felt, you know what I mean? So there hasn't been any issues or differences with that. Other than the nice peace of mind of security, my friend. The next question is, how long can the spotting after getting one last? For me, the spotting was kind of just like a regular period. It really didn't last that long. I want to say maybe 5 days, and then it went away, and then my period actually started on its like regular day. It was kind of weird. I didn't mention that, but there was obviously a little bit of bleeding and spotting on the first day and second day, and then it kind of just eased up. The next question is, did you notice you were getting UTIs more frequently? For me personally, I don't think I've ever had a UTI now that I'm like thinking about it. I'm super like adamant about like peeing after sex and stuff and doing my little things to hopefully prevent that, but from what I can recall, I don't think I've ever had one. Fingers crossed, knock on wood, that doesn't happen. What were some doubts you had before getting the IUD and how do you feel about them now? I don't know if I've had any like doubts. I think I was a little bit worried about maybe like using tampons with it. I thought maybe it could get caught on the strings. Even when it came to like trying out a menstrual cup, which if you guys want the period routine, I can talk about my experience with that and having an IUD. I thought that the suction would be like too intense to use a menstrual cup, that it would possibly pull out my IUD. And other than that, I don't think there was anything prior to getting it that I like doubted about it. I was a little bit naive and I was like, my period can't get that much worse. Yes, it can. And it will. But yeah, I think that's, I don't know if I answered your question, but that's kind of what comes to mind when I think of that. And the last question I have here to answer is it common to get scared about the IUD moving and not being as effective anymore? This is definitely something I've thought about. They actually suggest the clinic that I went to come in 1 year later to check the IUD to make sure it's in place. That's another thing. They did do like a little ultrasound, I think that's what it is, where they make sure it is in place after insertion, which is obviously very important and very good. I did go to kind of try and see if I could feel the strings one time. This was probably about 3 weeks after insertion, because they say if it is going to move, it'll probably happen within the first month or so. I think that's what they say. So I have felt the strings once. I haven't gone looking since, but I have felt them once, and that was good enough for me. I haven't really had any doubts since then, because I get my period pretty regularly. I haven't had any worries with that. And also too, when it comes to protection, we kind of use two methods anyway, even though this is 99% effective. We're just super cautious because I don't want to have a unplanned pregnancy. But other than that, I don't think there was any kind of feelings towards it moving or not being as effective. I have a lot of trust in it and the doctor and all of the things that, you know, led up to me having it placed in my body and how it's gone so far. That being said though, I'm definitely down to go and have it checked. Obviously, we are in a weird state of the world, so I'm not going to be making any medical appointments anytime soon, but when the time is right, I definitely want to schedule an appointment and just make sure everything is a-okay, but I don't really have any doubts. That's just more of a procedure thing because they suggested to do so. Well, friends, that was a very long video, but I really, really hope that this helped you out. If you guys are looking into different types of birth control, maybe you are getting an IUD or you don't know which one is best for you, I hope that my transparency and honesty was helpful to you guys, because I've actually went looking for an IUD video when I was about to get one and I couldn't really find any that like resonated with me, if that makes sense, or that was like super helpful in the thoughts and experiences that I was kind of looking for. So hopefully this was helpful to you if you guys were searching this video out. If this is the first time you're seeing my face on YouTube or coming across my channel, definitely subscribe. I would love to have you join the family. I love you all so much. Thank you so much for watching this video and watching it to the end. If you did, I really, really appreciate it. And I will see you guys in my next video. Have a great day. Bye.